Good day, welcome to Martinez Design. In this tutorial, we are going to expose graphic details of how to use different kind of graphics on a plan, how to adjust the detailing, the color of the building, making it a solid black, and so on and so forth. So follow up step by step on how we are going to work on this. So the first thing to need to do is that we want to change the color and the thickness of this wall. So now there are two graphics visibility in Revit. One is a graphics modifying, in which the first thing you do is that anytime you create you change your graphics here, is only affecting only the view here. The other part of the building or the plan are not affected. So we are going to explain this. Let's go. So now on your keyboard, or go to your view, so press visibility graphics or VG on the keyboard. So the same thing on keyboard, you press VG. Now on this category of visibility graphics on a plan, only this floor plan is going to work on. So what to do, let us try and see what I was talking about. So on the wall, as you click on the wall, go to cut pattern, the line, say graphics override. What to do is that you change the weight to something like 10 and say okay. Click appear, apply. Did you see? It's now bigger. Maybe you don't want it, you can now reduce the size to, okay, let's say something like 7 and say okay. So it's now is at a normal graphics level. Now as you are seeing these graphics here, if you go to another level, you are not going to see the graphics again. You see the graphics disappear. No matter how you toggle the graphics line, the tick line, it's not going to be showing. So that is the point of this one. So, but the one that is much common is that is the one I'm going to talk about here now. So press VG again, your graphics. So here now you click on object type. This one is categorized of everyone is going to override according to any field you click on. So let us try this one this time around. So now what we want to do is that we want to change it to solid black. Click on wall. Go to the last one, which is called wall default. Click on wall default. And the wall default, say background cut pattern. Change it to solid black. Say okay. Okay. So now you say apply. Did you see? Everything changed to solid black in this place. So when you change everything that changed to solid black, if you go to the, like we did for, go to the plan, you just see that everything is here changed. If you try to go to section as well, you're going to see solid black all over. Anywhere you click, you're going to see solid black. So that is visibility, how to represent visibility, or to change like this dark area now, and to adjust the section view to suit in the wall size. So then the scene is going to change and find itself there. So that is how you work on graphics visibility in a Revit. So like this place now, I want to change it back to normal, but a thick line, unlike before. So press VG again, your keyboard, object style. On the object style, go to wall and turn it back. You don't want that. So I want it to go back to none. I don't want to show in any way. Click OK. So apply it. Now go back to the same wall. What we want to do is to change the thickness of the cut plate. So now change it to something like 7. Say apply. Okay, now we have it here. So it's thick here. Now when you go to another level, you are going to find it thick. Are you saying it's go to your section, click on section, you see, and you click another section. So you see what we are saying here. So the thickness is there, the solid black is gone. So everywhere you go, even though you create another another view of section, you're going to find it there like that in the first place, that everything has been changed. So that is the responsibility of the same. Another thing is that you can cast shadow on your or your plan. So just click on shadow cast here. Did you see? It changes. So if you can do the same thing on the first floor level as well, cast shadow again. So everywhere you click on shadow, it's going to change. You can adjust the shadow when you go to graphic display option, like using your lights, change the height, the azimuth, and the heavy other thing that you need that is necessary. Let's use 165. Okay, and say apply. And the altitude, let it be 25. Click it and say apply. And you see, it's charging, is going to be directing and be changing. So the same thing, to return it back to the way it was or something, little bits. So, like this one, 20, change it to 180. So click apply. You see it? So, one is everything is aligned, it just only one side is same. So, can change it to 175. So, let it be like one. Okay, that is normal. And change this to something like 10. Apply. So you can change your graphics the way you want in graphics, and you look more presentable when you send this one as your presentation to a client. So this one is more a little bit of advanced. You are not going to see all this shadow in another field until you toggle it and you do the same thing, you adjust it in the field, that is how it works. So in the Revit, if you go to section, you cannot see shadow once you cast shadow on the section where you set. So cast shadow here again. You are using it, so you can adjust the shadow the way we did in that one. Click on this visibility display. So on your lighting, click and adjust this one to what we've been doing before, 165 by 15. Do that first and say apply. You see me? So this appearance gives you, so you adjust the shadow to suit you the way you want it to be, with the little bits of shadows that you want on your education. So that is how you work on this and to great beauty on your birthday today. So a little bit of graphic aspiration is what we have displayed here. So please kindly like, click subscribe to follow us. So we are doing, when we do another tutorial, you'll be able to get it and continue focusing on developing yourself.